Typically, if an apostle gift, the anointing, apostolic is your primary calling, you're going to tilt a little more toward the wisdom and the knowledge side of things. The more prophetic you are, you're going to tilt toward the revelatory side of things. And one is not, it's not that one is better or more important. It's that these things were designed, these two gifts were designed to work together. And so this is why it's the foundation, he says, of the church. Built on the foundation of apostles and prophets. And the first two gifts, first, apostle, prophet, these are the two. You got to hear what he's saying and you got to know how to do it. Some people hear what he's saying, they don't know how to do it, they mess it up. You can know what, but if you don't know how, you mess it up. Then you got all these people that they've been taught how. And they can build, man, they're great builders, and they're building the wrong thing. It stinks. Because they haven't had a fresh word from God in 10 years. And he wants to bring this. They're both aspects of Christ's anointing that he gave to us. And we must have both. So, who else? There's another. Oh, the sons of Issachar. Yes. This is what they had. They had this mix of wisdom and revelation. 1 Chronicles 12:32 says, this is the word. Now, this is not the predominant word for wisdom in the Old Testament. It's not the predominant word for revelation. When this one is used, it's a mix. This is what Issachar had, which gave them an understanding of the times so Israel could know what to do. They had a mix anointing that could tap into wisdom and revelation. And we throw that verse around a lot, and it's a good one to throw around. But most people couldn't tell you the context of that verse. But the context of that verse in 1 Chronicles 12 is describing David's army, his mighty men had helped him. And the verse 1 and verse 38, both the beginning and end of that chapter, describe them as these are the people that helped him in war. It wasn't just, you know, helping decide how to build the city, lay out this part of the nation or that. Specifically, that's put in the middle of this passage about war. If we're going to win the war for America, nations, we can only do it through this mix of wisdom and revelation, apostolic and prophetic anointings and giftings working together. So, I hope you leaders are getting this. This is. I just get sidetracked in all these little bunny trails I want to go down, but this, I will say this much. This is why God is, he's trying to take us to level after level of more of mature operating of with apostles and prophets working together. Have to work together. And prophets cannot do what they need to do without the apostolic gifting and anointing. Now, some of them have both, but even if you have both, you need other people in your life to do this. So it's no, it doesn't bother me in the least when I'm with a prophetic company of people that can prophesy or hear things in the spirit better than I can. That doesn't bother me in the least. It doesn't bother me to sit down and let them take over. Because I need what they have, that revelation. And most of them that I run with, all of them that I run with, because I wouldn't run with them if it wasn't true, but if they're mostly prophet, they know they need the apostolic anointing in me. Because God's taught me some things they don't know. And so when we stop playing the kingdom games of competition and building our own kingdoms, and get me off on this stuff, and you make a preacher want to cuss. I get so tired of it. But if we can marry these things. So my daughter has a dream years ago, Hannah, and in the dream, it's for me. She says, Dad, I had this dream, and in the dream, you and Mom were taking me to college. She's only, 14, 15, I don't know, but in the dream, she was going off to college, and we were taking her. And so we took her in a building to check her in, and they said to her, the first thing you have to do is you have to go down the street here to this store and you have to get new shoes. So we took her there and we were really surprised. She said, Dad, I was really surprised in the dream. We got there. It was a Safeway. You have Safeways here? It's a supermarket. Like Kroger. So she said, I can't get shoes. But anyway, she said, this is where they told me to come. So went in, sure enough, they had the shoes I needed that they told me to get. So those shoes in a dream speak of a journey, a path, a travel, transition maybe. What? So she said, Dad, I was so surprised when we walked out. I was so surprised that we had gotten them in Safeway. I looked back at the store one more time and the sign had changed. And it wasn't called Safeway. The name of the store was now Other Things. And the Lord, as I'm praying and processing this, he said, where I'm about to take you, you can't get there by going the Safeway. Because I'm going to do some other things. And you're going to have to get out of your comfort zone. The way that you have learned and been taught to do things. Not that they were bad even. It's just, I'm doing other things.